Allora, che cosa sapete di quello che state per vedere?
Vediamo gli elicotteri.
For Stockhausen there was a need, and I think that's the only way he could write a string quartet. Because, you know, composers had written string quartets, lots of composers. I think Stockhausen felt he couldn't write a string quartet. He'd never written for strings. He'd always written for orchestra or electronic things or tam-tams or this or that, woodwind. But he wrote a wind quintet, but never a string quartet. And I think he felt a bit uncomfortable, to be honest. He was a bit uncomfortable to write a string quartet.
I asked him many times, and many times he said, "I don't write string quartets."
So for Stockhausen, he had to find another idea. He had to find a way to satisfy me, because he knew I was a great fan of his music. And he had to find a way to do this, because I think he wanted to do it, but he didn't. So he found, as always with him, you know, each new piece in the beginning was something different, something special. And this was really special, something really incredible. And it works. He got it, but maybe you have to be Stockhausen to make it work. Not everyone can write for helicopters.
Non abbiamo mai visto una cosa del genere.
Voglio suonare in un elicottero.
Perché?
Perché amo la musica e perché mi piacciono gli elicotteri.
A me non piacerebbe, mi sentirei un po' in pericolo, seduto su una sedia senza...
Hanno fatto risuonare la musica più interessante e più antica.
Un po'... noioso, sì.
Era bello, però era un po'
noioso
perché era sempre la stessa roba.
String quartet is a unit. I mean, we don't do much else. We play together all the time. And if you're playing with your colleagues every day, there's a unity that you can never have with other groups. We've been responsible for creating a huge repertoire of string quartets, and I didn't really realize it when I was doing it, but over 39 and a half years, which it now is, there's a huge repertoire of string quartets that probably wouldn't have been written.
Why are there not so many good Brazilian composers?
I refuse to answer that question. I went, I did an audition, I played 10 pieces with a quartet. It all went very well. It was very nice. So I started playing the quartet. In the first year in the Adige Quartet, I think I played about 100 or 300 quartets, different quartets. I can't remember. So that is the first challenge of playing in a quartet that has got such a big, such a difficult repertoire.
It was my enthusiasm and then the quartet's enthusiasm. To be interested in new music, and composers heard about us. We didn't really have to do very much. Composers knew about us, so we'd play one composer, and then we'd play Fernie Howe, and Fernie Howe says, "Oh yes, they're very good." So then we play Jonathan Harvey, then we play Ligeti, then we play Xenakis, and it's like a snowball.
You start from Penderecki.
In the very first concert.
Yeah.
In 1974.
Oh, it was.
Oh, very interesting working with him, because we were very... I was just finished being a student, and it set the mood for the way the quartet would work for the next 40 years, because working with Penderecki was finding out what he wanted, and this for me was very interesting, to find out what Penderecki wanted and to play the music the way the composers wanted. And this was the way I wanted to set up the quartet. After working in the beginning with a composer, I thought this was a really great thing to be able to do. And for me, playing contemporary music became the most important thing.
Perché si viene a un concerto così?
Perché mi ci porta mia moglie.
Ogni tanto ci si aggiorna per vedere un po' che cosa produce questo mondo, che continua a essere un mondo troppo accademizzato. Aspettiamo il giorno in cui per musica contemporanea si intenderà tutta la musica vitale che si fa oggi.
I refuse to answer questions like what's music going to be like in 20 years time or in 100 years time or which pieces will be played in the next century. It doesn't matter. These questions aren't important. What is important is that it's the art of today. And if it doesn't survive or people are not interested to listen to it, that's just the way it is. But I don't like to answer these questions because my whole ideal in life is to perform this music, to live it, to be inside it, and not to worry. I don't care if the audience like it or don't like it. Our job on the stage is to play the music, to live the music, and also to carry it down to the next generation.
Che strumento suoni?
Chitarra.
Tu?
Flauto.
Chi altro?
Percussioni. Pianoforte.
Altri strumenti?
Percussioni.
Batteria.
Pianoforte.
Pianoforte.
Batteria.
Perché quando io ho parlato di Stockhausen in classe e quando ho fatto leggere quella cosa, tutti erano al settimo cielo e volevano vedere questi elicotteri.
I mean, all we can do is to play this music as best as we can. And if people are interested, they will come and they will listen to it. But in a way, that's not really our job to interest contemporary music. It should be more the job of the educational institutions to bring the children maybe to concerts, contemporary music concerts. And actually, children probably will understand it and like it much better than adults will. Adults who have kind of all this weight of the tradition that, you know, music has to be, there has to be a melody, there has to be a certain harmony and so on. All this stops you off to really listen to the music. And children in a way are much more open to it, and they hear, you know, a music and they'll love it. They'll just, also I find that many people who don't know much about classical music come to our concerts and they love it because they listen just to the music without any preconceptions of what music should be like. And that's the wonderful thing about contemporary music. You know, there's no preconception. Everything is new. You just always listen with kind of fresh ears to the music.
Cosa vogliamo suggerire ai nuovi compositori?
Di non ripetere sempre le stesse cose.
Di fare qualcosa di più allegro.
Di fare qualcosa di meno lungo.
Di non suonare con l'aereo sotto.